Hello YouTube, and hello to my dear subscribers. Thank you all for watching to one of my videos. And today it's going to be about the review, spoiler free, for Bravely Default by Square Enix, released for the Nintendo 3DS. And I just completed the game 1 hour ago, so the ending is still fresh in my memory. And I already made a first impressions video about 3 weeks ago, and some stuff I talked over in the first impressions will be discussed here, but I found some new stuff to talk about as well. So I'll first show you. Let's talk about the game time. How many hours to beat Bravely Default? And it's a complete playthrough. I did all the side quests and everything that's is possible in this game. So let's show you the amount of hours of game playtime of game time you will have with Bravely Default. And that is, if you can read it, 77 hours and 50 minutes. So let's make that 78, approximately 78 to 80 hours of game time for this amazing game. So basically that's very, very worth its money. And like I said, it took me about 3 weeks. I have not played any other game, just Bravely Default. I truly wanted to finish it or complete the game. Because with some games at the half I get bored or something. But this game pulled me in and pulled me through to the ending. And yeah, it's to my opinion the very good Final Fantasy. I heard from others it's really the successor to Four Heroes of Light for the Nintendo DS. But I have never played Four Heroes of Light, so I am not able to compare it in any way. But it's got all the good stuff from the old Final Fantasies. And by that I mean the item names, Phoenix Down, all the familiar things from Final Fantasy. Job classes, black mage, white mage, monk, ninja, knight, they are all back. So yeah, Whisper Ocean, she asked me, is this game, is it worth to buy a 3DS for this game? I know the 3DS is not very cheap. I will not recommend buy the 2DS, just buy, if you have some money, buy the 3DS XL. It's a fantastic great handheld. And this game, yeah, is it worth spending $160 on the 3DS for playing a game? It's very, very, very good Final Fantasy. And there are many, or there are some other great 3DS games that I'm sure you will enjoy. So yeah, is it worth it? Yeah, if you have the money, it's worth it. It's truly a great game. If it had been released on the PlayStation 1, it would have been 5 CDs. That's approximately how big the game is, in gigabyte in size, that is. So it's basically a 5 CD PlayStation 1 title on the 3DS. And the battles, they are turn-based. Just the way I like it. I'm really fond of turn-based battles like Dragon Quest 8 or Persona games. And there are many other good turn-based games. But this one is also very, very, very well done. Very good battle system. And what makes it so special is there are lots of job classes you can select. So it's not like Final Fantasy X, that Waka is the one with the ball, so he's good against flyers. And there is a one black mage and a white mage and a fighter. But here you can give each character in your party the class that you think will be best for that session grind or the boss you are going to encounter. And there are about 16, maybe more, but approximately 16 job classes you can select for all the four characters in your party. And each character can execute two job classes. So you can have a combination of a ninja white mage, or a black mage spellcaster, a monk ninja. It is however you like it. You can do those two job classes with your character. And yeah, each job class has 14 levels. So you'll be grinding, especially in the beginning of the game, you'll be grinding just to raise your job classes to a good level. Because a level 1 black mage, yeah, she can only do like fire spell, and level 3 magic will be Fyra, and it's that kind of Final Fantasy stuff, Blizzard, Blizzara, Blizzaga, something. So all the good stuff from Final Fantasy is in it. The characters are very well done. I really have a feeling at the end, or well, during the game as well, you get to know the characters, their history. So it's not a blend, some characters and no, they each have their own story, their own characteristics. So yeah, and you basically play with four people. That's your party, four fixed people. And without making spoilers, the story is save the world. That's all I'm gonna say. And that's in most Final Fantasies, it's save the world from something. And also in this game, that's the case. And in between the battles, you have skits like in Tales of games. So party members talk with each other, and during these conversations you learn more about the characters and the characteristics. So that's another good plus. The amount of voice acting in this game is amazing. I said that in my latest video, it got more voice acting than Virtuous Last Reward. And if you have not played Virtuous Last Reward, there was already a lot of voice acting. And in this game it's really, really, almost everything is voice acted. Just the skits are not voice acted, but the rest is all voice acted. Conversations with bosses, with party members, so much. And you can select the Japanese or the English voice actors. And personally, I liked the Japanese voice actors more, so I switched to Japanese the first day and kept it on Japanese voice acting. And so there is a lot, and in two languages. Lots of story, lots of to do. It got side quests, but not in the style of gather kill this 20 times or gather this. The side quests are really story based and are basically a part of the larger picture of the bigger story. They are, you do not have to do them, but like I said, they are part of the bigger story. And you get to know your characters and a little bit more about the world and the people you meet. So it's recommendable doing the side quests, of course. And yeah, to enjoy the game fully, I think you really should do every quest that is available. The music is very good in this game. And for me, I was glad to see there is an option to switch the music off during the boring grinding sessions during grinding sessions, mindless grinding sessions. I like to listen to TV or other videos on YouTube, so it's you can switch off the music, so that will not disturb your concentration on other things. that's a very good add-on for this game as well. In-game you can switch difficulty. You can switch from easy to normal to hard in-game, wherever you are like. So if you meet a boss that is too hard, you can switch. You can always switch one level back. And on easy, it's really, really easy. And basically, I kept the game on normal. Besides, I think one or two mid bosses, or how would you say, two side quest bosses that were giving me a hard time. So at that point I switched to easy to get through those bosses and then switch back to normal. So that's also included in the game. And the characters are very enjoyable. They are it's a nice gathering of four people going to save the world. Well, basically five, because Agnes has a little fairy with her that helps us on the way. And that's basically why the game is called the Bravely Default, where the fairy flies. So basically you have five party members, but the fairy doesn't attack or do something. She just talks sometimes. Yeah, it's definitely in my top 5 of favorite games for this year. Definitely not in a number 1 or 2 spot, but number 3, 4 or 5. I still have to make a top 10 for this year, but this game is surely going to be in the top 5 of best games for this year. And I'm very glad Square Enix released this game, besides the Final Fantasy series we have on the PlayStation 3. This game would even be a good game on the console. And it's really amazing how they put this in the 3DS. The surroundings look 2D but are 3D. That's also how they do that. That is a great thing. Everything looks hand-drawn, and lots of is hand-drawn. But half 3D, half 2D. It's hard to explain, but if you play the game, you'll see what you'll notice what I see. So the graphics are very, very great as well. It's an open world. It's not clear one region, then go to the next region, then go to the next region, follow this path, follow that path. It's one big open world. And the further you go, it's more easy, of course, to travel to some other places on the world map. But it's kind of a large map. It looks not so big, but when you walk from the one side of the map to the other side of the map, you'll have quite a walk. And there are lots of towns to visit where you can buy new spells, new armor, new weapons, all that kind of good stuff. So I'll if you're a Final Fantasy fan, I'll truly recommend buying this game. But most of all of you watching from the USA, you already have plans buying this game. And it's as good as you are hoping that it will be. So that's basically the review. What else to say? It's, for me, it's over. It's not game over, but it's the end. And somehow it feels like it's a shame. It's I'm not gonna play it again now, but it's starting to look for another game, and I still have to complete Digital Devil Saga and Legends of Heroes. So I still have my other games, but yeah, I was so fond of this game, and now it's over, and that's kind of a shame, but no game can last forever. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked the review. It's if you want to hear more about my opinion about this game, in my playlist, there is, or in my videos, there's a first impression as well for this game. If you like to hear more, I had some other thoughts about this game, also positive, but maybe you'll find more information. Again, it's as well non-spoiler. Basically, I want to thank you all for watching, and you'll see me next time. Bye bye from Kaida.